What's up, YouTube? My name's JD, and I'm the dude behind Red Barrel Skis. Today, I want to show you my ski press. What's a ski press? Well, it's a big piece of machinery you use to combine all the layers of a ski and to give it its camber. It's got lots of parts and pieces, so let's get into it. So let's start from the inside and work our way out and go through each layer in kind of the context of a virtual layup. Right here, this is the lower mold. It is what gives the ski its camber. Cut that out on a CNC'er with a template, with whatever kind of early rise or reverse camber or whatever camber you're trying to give your ski. When I'm laying up a pair of skis, start with that, and then roll out a heater blanket. This is a silicone blanket with a bunch of resistive wire embedded throughout. I use 16-gauge sheet metal as the contact surfaces for what makes contact with the ski. I'll cover this in mold release, I'll plop down all my layers, and then use a matching piece to create the sandwich of what encloses the ski during the press. Add some more heat to protect this upper blanket. I use a piece of masonite with a bunch of slits kind of cut widthwise up in the tip and the tail to help it curve for the tip and the tail. This whole assembly gets carefully shoved back into the press. Some press designs just open up on the top. That's pretty sweet. This one, I just have to shove it in from the side, but works for me. This is what I call the cat tracks. It's just a bunch of steel beams. I use a little bit skinnier wooden beams at the tip and the tail just to allow it to get a little more curvature. They're connected with a steel cable running lengthwise, and then they're suspended off this bungee cord. This is a lay flat or fire hose, and it's controlled off a little pneumatic controls, which again I'll show you more about later. And then the upper mold, which is just kind of the reverse of the lower mold. It's a little skinnier just so that you have some room for the thickness of the cat tracks and the blanket up in the tip and the tail. And then from here to here is the structure of the press. It's made from 2 8-inch wide, 10-foot long I-beams, giving the press a 16-inch width. They're 10 feet long, and then on the ends I have 6-inch by 6-inch square beams, 2 tall, giving it a 12-inch tall internal kind of cavity height, 16-inch wide and 9 feet long. Let's go check out those electronic and pneumatic controls. This slightly chaotic mess of cables and hoses are the controls for the ski press. Let's see if I can make some sense of it all. Over here we've got the electrical controls. It's driven off a 220-volt outlet. The main brain to the operation is this self-tuning PID controller. You can use these little buttons on the face to pick your temperature. The temperature sensor itself is a thermocouple that I sandwich between the blankets and the sheet metal. It drives a solid-state relay inside this box that connects the 220 volts out to the heater blankets themselves. These blankets are 2700 watts, so they're very, very powerful. They heat up very quick and they can get really, really hot. There's a couple fuses in line with the blankets to make sure they don't get too hot. And then over here, we've got the pneumatic controls. So starts off with an air compressor. Use the pressure regulator on the air compressor to determine the pressure inside of the press. This lever has 3 positions. The lower position lets air flow from the compressor into the blankets. The middle position just cuts it off so no air can flow at all. And then the upper position lets air flow back out of the blankets and through this small brass diffuser. Over here, this is just a manifold which keeps all these ports at the same pressure level. This is a pop safety valve so you don't accidentally put too much pressure in your press. And then this is a simple pressure readout. You also have one on the press. They're usually 1 or 2 PSI, no different. So that's a good sign that everything's working just fine. And there you have it, the controls for a ski press. On a final note, more serious note, I gotta mention that these machines are pretty incredibly dangerous. They run at high pressures, high temperatures, off high voltages, and can hurt you more ways than one. This video was not intended to be an instructional on how to build or design a ski press. It's just a 101 on how I use it. That being said, thank you so much for watching. Please like and subscribe. And as I used to always say at the ski shop, ski fast, take chances. Thanks.